Just that realization that we hadn't been, you know, for the most of the season, you know, that's been a soft spot for us. So just trying to come out, we talked about it this morning, shoot around and just really focusing on ourselves and different ways we can get better. And that was one of them. Just making sure we came out with a competitive defensive focus. And we were plus one for the quarter, but, you know, it's just a never-ending journey, just trying to improve day after day, game after game, each shoot-around. We barely get to practice, so shoot-arounds have become like our practices. So today, you know, we did a lot of things where we needed to clean up ourselves, and it was more about us this morning than all due respect to Orlando. You know, they're a great young ball club, but we needed to focus on ourselves and do some self-health checks basketball-wise.
What type of adjustment you guys have been making?
I mean, everyone just doing more, you know what I mean? Us being versatile and, you know, no one knows exactly when Anthony will be coming back, but in the meantime, guys got to step up. You know, we have to, you know, not just our big guys, you know, everyone as a unit, be more locked in, be more cohesive, more competitive. And you're never going to replace a player of that magnitude, but what you can do is just everyone share the load. Like the ball movement tonight was one of the examples of how you can try to weather that storm. We had 32 assists, six different people in double figures. That's the way you do it. Everyone pitches in and everyone helps pull their end of the rope and all pull in the same direction at that.
Darvin, you talked about force before the game and doesn't like trying to make up to their size. They hit the last, I think, six rebounds in the first quarter, offensive rebounds, I'm sorry. Won the next two. I didn't see the fourth quarter stats yet, but what did you think of your team's force sort of in the eye of their size?
I thought it was great. You know, you start with the matchup with Paolo and Pat Bev. It's like just him just being physical and not allowing anything easy, doing his work early, forcing tough catches, being there, forcing them to go into a counter move or an escape move, and all four other guys on the court being, you know, in unison, shifted, ready to help out, multiple contests, multiple efforts to close out. That's what we have to be. That has to be our identity. That's what we're striving for. But just playing a physical ball game and getting hits once the shot went up, like you mentioned, their size, their athleticism is really daunting. The challenge is daunting, man. When you see those guys on the court, you really see it where I'm from, my vantage point, like how big and athletic these kids are. And it's like, we got to get the first hit, you know, legal hits. For sure, but getting a hit and multiple guys going in to get and attacking the glass defensively to get those boards and holding the one possession.
So part of your job as a coach is to bring these guys as a team, is to make the individuals comfortable, to make them feel like they have you know, some agency in what's going on. And Russell, for so long, identified himself, or was identified as this triple-double genius. And now, in this new role, feel like that's something that's not the carrot is winning, but be able to do that in the context of winning in this new role is something that you know, you feel like you've done a good job finding a new role for him.
I think we have. I mean, he's sacrificed. You know, he could have fought it, and you know, we instead put our heads together and looked and took a good long hard look at the balance. See, this. You have to realize that an NBA lineup has to have balance. It's not so much of can he start or his starting days are over. It's not about that. It's about him being able to bring a counterpunch, a new extra wave, a higher pace off the bench along with, you know, some of our rotation guys. And him having that confidence and him still performing at a starter level, at an all-star level off the bench, you mentioned the triple-doubles. It gives those other guys confidence as well. and he can kind of orchestrate and dictate different things and really be involved. And now we're finding different actions with he and LeBron in middle pick and rolls or side pick and rolls. And their symmetry and their synergy together is becoming even more and more productive for us. And I'm just, you know, kudos to him being a professional. I know it's been hard certain moments in time, and just him just continuing just to fight and compete and do everything that's asked of him from that position and from that role.
Darvin, I know the shots can really come in from anywhere, but that being said, when guys who have had some up and downs with their shooting, like Pat Bev and Troy tonight, do you just have a little extra, you know, fist pump for those guys seeing their shot going tonight?
Yeah, I love it, and we encourage that. You know, let it fly, man. Like that's the biggest thing. You're open, you have to shoot it. And I trust them. I have confidence in them. It's something we work at, you know, whenever we practice or individual vitamins. So, yeah, they get in the reps. And now, you know, when the opportunity presents itself in the game, and they have to have confidence. And it's always good when you see the ball go in several times over. And it just makes them that much more confident to shoot the ball. And everyone is encouraging these guys to shoot the ball. Even, you know, miss or make, you know, you got to stay aggressive.
Do you have a sense for LeBron's availability tomorrow?
I have a sense that I'm probably not going to tell you right now. Coach, I love you, Dan. Love you, Dan.
Coach, outside of the injuries, what do you feel is the most challenging part of being a coach, especially in the first year? What's been the most challenging or learning experience that you pretty much sticking in your head?
I think that what goes into preparation, and as you mentioned, the injuries are something that's a very real part of our business, something that you, no matter, you know it's going to happen eventually, you don't want it to happen, but it's something that you're going to have to deal with, and you never know who that injury bug is going to bite, and you just have to be prepared. And that's why, you know, I've surrounded myself with a extremely high level basketball coaching staff, and we have a extremely high level medical staff, and everybody within the organization, you know, just trying to keep things together and being ready to adjust if need be. And, you know, unfortunately we have different guys out of lineup currently, as Anthony and Juan, and, you know, just being able to pivot, being ready to pivot and have a plan, and not just a plan A, but a plan B and C. And so just, I credit my coaching staff. It's no one thing that, you know, that I'm taking all the responsibility upon myself. Like, we share the load around here, and we put different beautiful, bright minds in the room and see what we come up with, and usually it's a great plan.
Coach, you've done a great job at coaching a variety of skill sets. So at this point, what is it like coaching so many players with such high IQs, who've seen so many different schemes? What is that like on a night-in, night-out basis?
It's great, and just trying to get them to understand that we have to keep it simple. You know, just keep it simple. We don't want to have paralysis by over-analysis. And we come with a simple plan defensively, a simple plan offensively, and try to stick to it and develop some consistency with that. This game, you know, it's a lot of different elements to it that you can get kind of lost in the woods a little bit if you're constantly trying to, you know, solve each and every scenario or try to stop everything another team does, as opposed to going in with a mindset of this is what we're going to live with and this is how we're going to play on the other end of the floor, and sticking to that and just constantly harping and being consistent with your message. From myself all the way down to my coaching staff and everybody, just having a consistent message.
Appreciate it. Thanks, Coach. Yep.